Okay, students, very good morning to all of you. Beta, we have already discussed introduction to the service marketing, growth and development of service sector economy, service marketing mix, contribution of service sector to Indian economy, characteristics of service sector, classification of service sectors. So in the previous lecture, last lecture, we have discussed customer expectations of services under the heading of consumer behavior in services. So beta, in our today lecture, we will discuss customer perception of services, service quality, integrated gaps model of service quality, prescriptions of closing service quality gaps. So with today's lecture, we will finish our first unit, and in next lecture, we will discuss the second unit of syllabi. So let's start the lecture of day. So content of the lectures are service quality, integrated gaps model of service quality, prescriptions of closing service quality gaps. But as far as the definition of perception is concerned, according to Joseph, perception includes all those processes by which an individual receives information about his environment, seeing, hearing, feeling, tasting, and smelling. So perception means what we are receiving from our environment through our observation, through our hearing, through our feeling, through our tasting, through our smelling, and through our senses. It is all about your own perception, all about your positive attitude, your negative attitude, your feeling regarding any event. So it means that perception is directly related to the human psychology. So for the same event, one person may have different perception and another person may have the different perception. For the same services, for the same product, customer have the different perception and another customers have the different perception. So perception is a qualitative aspect, perception is a subjective aspect, and it's all related to, and it's all vary according to the human psychology, according to the human observation, and according to the human mind capacities. So next one, what is perception? What is the meaning of perception? So perception means that same universe is viewed differently by different person, as we have already discussed. It doesn't matter, you may experience your all the things in a similar way as you perceive. But just a minute. It is the process through which information from outside environment is selected, received, organized, and interpreted to make it meaningful to us. So perception directly related to what we are receiving from our environment, how do we receive it, how to analyze it, and how do we make our mind towards any specific services, towards any specific products. There is a common perception in the mind of customer that the product of specific company is not up to the mark. I think we may take the example from China product. So we all know that the cost of China product is not too much high. All the products are inexpensive. But when we talk about the quality of product, there is a common perception among the Indians that China products are not higher quality. China product has substandards. So it means that this is a perception of consumer. So when we talk about compare our product of Indian company to the Japan, Germany, France, and America, all the developed nation, then we assume that the production or manufacturing of developed nation, the quality of their product is much higher than Indian product. So it means that this is subject to the perception of people and experience of people. The next one is it is a process by which individual organize and interpret their sensory impression in order to give meaning to the environment. So it's all about the capacity of human mind, how to receive, how to evaluate, and how to interpret the information what we have received from the environment. And this is all about the perception of mind. So what we are, what we have, it means that this is all about the perception, what we have in mind, and the lifestyle of person, education of person, income level of person, exposure of a person. All these things influence the perception of person very much. So if you have good knowledge, then you can make your perception accordingly. So beta, next one. Students, am I audible to all?
Yes,
sir. Okay, beta.
Yes.
Hello, beta. Am I audible to all?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
sir. Okay, beta. Factor influencing perception of customer. So first one is people or service personnel. I think that human source is the one of the most important asset of any organization. When we talk about the previous time, when we talk about the before industrialization, when we talk about the last century's time period, so at that time, majority of the industrialists feel that human source is the burden of company. And their main focus was to how to reduce the cost of human sources, how to get the maximum work from the human sources, and how to channelize the activity of human source to get the maximum benefit and pay the minimum. But after the revolution in the industrialization, so majority of the people, majority of the industrialists and entrepreneurs feel that human source is the one of the most important asset of any organization to deal with the machine, money, and material. There is a human source who can deal, who can use, who can implement all the policies of higher level management in a proper way. So as far as when we talk about regarding the importance of personnel in company, at that time, personnel or human source is at the top of hierarchy of all the factors which are available to the company. So personnel services play an important role in defining and quality of service encountered in the mind of the customer. In this case, we may take the example of McDonald's. And I think you have you may feel that when we visit any franchise, internationally established franchise, the way of delivering the services is the same. All the people are very much trained. All the people are very much humble. All the people are very much positive towards the delivery of services. And they take care of all the customers, whether they belong to age 5 or 50 or 80. It means that all the human source which is available within the company are well trained, and they are the face of company. When we talk about service industry, when we talk about service marketing, there is a thin line difference between a service and its delivery. Majority of the time, the service delivery is itself a service. So way to deliver the service, the who deliver the service is itself a service. In this case, we may take the example of doctors, teachers, advocate, CA, or investment banker. So in all type of industry, human source play a very significant role to attract the consumer, to satisfy the consumer. So beta, next one, process of service delivery. So process of service delivery means it involves large number of activities, but all the activities are flexible and standardized in nature to provide the same level of experience to the customer. So as far as the academic meaning, it involves the various steps in the process of delivering services and the flow of operational activities. But a service itself are nothing. This is the flow of activity. When you visited the restaurant, when you visited the airport, when you visited the hospitals, when you visited any service related office, then there is a flow of activities which provide or deliver the services to the consumer. So this is a flow of operational activities. This is a service process, which is well standardized by the company. So you may visit the Ahmedabad, you may visit the Gurgaon, you may visit the Delhi, but you get the same services in McDonnell, you may get the same services from the Airtel, you may get the same services from Singapore Airlines. So delivery of services, process of services are the same. But the next one, physical environment, I think we have already discussed in our previous lecture, tangible environment of the company. So it creates an impact on consumer perception. The physical environment consists of ambience offered by a service provider and a design of interior or exterior of the service facility. So physical environment means where we get the services. In this case, I think hotel industry is a very suitable example for this. When you visited any hotel, so aura of the hotel will positively or negatively influence your mind regarding the credibility and regarding the services of hotel. Human source who are available in the hotel, they influence the mind of customer regarding the quality of services. The food they deliver, they influence the mind of customer. The treatment and the preparation of room play a significant role in this. So physical environment play a very significant role in this.